our great humanity. You know when you meet somebody and there's a warmth there, and they just naturally flow into the way they communicate with you.
Mm-hmm.
Rather than somebody who says and he starts quoting every mathematical equation that Einstein and everybody came up with, and they just kind of bombard you with information.
Yeah.
You can just go like, excuse me, I'm really...
Because you haven't met them yet.
What's going on with your friend? You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So, you know, somebody's humanity is so important.
Yeah.
And that's what Wynton Kelly has. He has that humanity that draws people into the music.
Are you filming this?
You know.
This.
Oh, cool. So, my question to you, Tim, is that jazz has a particular sound, and I think the saxophone is the instrument that is most identifiable with jazz. It's when someone holds a saxophone player, they're like, oh, you're so cool, you must play jazz. And it's sort of cool and jazz seem to go hand in hand. But when a person first starts playing the saxophone, it sounds awful, like the sound of it. And what's so lovely about jazz is the sound of it, the sound particularly of the saxophonists, sounds really jazzy, and it has that warmth and that professionalism. How, as a saxophonist, talking to the younger and newer students to the instrument, how do you start to develop your sound? Orally, I'm saying.
Mm.
That actual sound.
It's very difficult to do this without some tuition, first of all, because the tuition hopefully will get you out of some bad habits, which... You know, that, and that will be the end of the picture. For example, especially when you're playing a saxophone, if you pinch, for example, too much on this reed, simply not enough air will be able to get down the instrument. And some people go for years without kind of realizing that central fact. And what we call the embouchure then has to be strengthened, and so you can play and hold the mouthpiece firmly, but without pinching it.
Mm-hmm.
And trumpet players have a similar kind of thing, where they learn to play with a great deal of energy, but very little pressure,
mm-hmm.
so they don't bust themselves up, you know. But I think when it comes to finding... And jazz, as you say, is so much about celebration of individuality, isn't it? The
mm-hmm.
personality, the individual. I'm blessed with playing an instrument which allows you to find... It doesn't come with so much of a ready-made sound. You can find your own sound on it. And to do that, once you've kind of learnt the basics, you know, the scales and the arpeggios, and that does take some patience to do all of that, through listening, just what you were saying yourself, through listening, and you start to simply imitate what you hear. You know, there's a very famous phrase that imitation, assimilation, and then innovation. You got those three in that order. Everything starts with imitation, doesn't it?
It does.
Language.
But,
yeah, exactly.